Welcome to the Cybersecurity Speaker Series, presented by NSA's Cybersecurity Collaboration Center. Our mission is to augment and amplify NSA's ability to prevent and eradicate threats to national security systems and the defense industrial base by establishing open, robust, and collaborative relationships across industry and government. Through bidirectional threat intelligence sharing and joint analytic tradecraft development, these partnerships leverage unique talents and capabilities to enhance cybersecurity across the nation. In this series, you'll hear about the work we do here and its real-world applications, bringing these insights to you through some of the top minds at NSA.
Welcome to the Speaker Series from NSA's Cybersecurity Collaboration Center. I'm Josiah Dykstra, a technical fellow here at NSA. In this series, we invite NSA experts to come share their insights, their expertise, and their contributions in the area of cybersecurity. With me today are Neal, the Technical Director for Cybersecurity, and Christen, a technical leader here at NSA. Welcome to you both.
Thanks, Josiah.
Thank you, Josiah.
Our topic today is vulnerability disclosure. People are seeing more and more public credit to NSA in some big and some small vulnerabilities. And I wonder if we can talk a little bit about what is NSA's role in that space. Christen, would you like to start?
Sure, Josiah. Just to back up just a little bit, our lives are increasingly interconnected and technology dependent. So for NSA to fulfill our missions of both cybersecurity and foreign signals intelligence, we need to build trust and partner with others globally in both industry and academia. Vulnerability discovery and responsible disclosure is one way to help build trust and partner with others. NSA has a long history of doing vulnerability research and discovery, and when you think about our missions, you can see how it's applicable. So first, for cybersecurity, we want to study the systems that underpin our way of life and our government, and make sure that we can trust these systems with our most important national security functions. For foreign signals intelligence, vulnerabilities can help us gain intelligence. Here at NSA, we have a lot of talented people who really thrive on tackling hard problems. And vulnerability research and discovery is definitely one of those hard problems. It takes a lot of persistence and deep understanding of complex systems to be successful. And it's something that we've really tried to put some concerted effort into in the last few years to help build up that skill set, because as I mentioned, it's really applicable to NSA's missions. Responsible disclosure is really important when we realize that we have to get something fixed. And working with our partners and industry is sometimes the fastest and the best way to get those weaknesses addressed.
Neal, how does NSA's expertise and how does our piece of this puzzle fit into the whole of government process?
Thank you for asking that, Josiah, because I think that's an important part of the story here. NSA, as Christen pointed out, has some great vulnerability discoverers. We also have folks who study how to mitigate vulnerabilities. And it's really important, given how all of our lives and government and national security are all interconnected, all depend on this technology, that we take a whole of government view of finding the best course of action with a given vulnerability for the benefit to the nation. For NSA, this is all about the best way to support our national interest. So NSA is a full participant in a whole of government process run out of the National Security Council called the Vulnerability Equities Process. And if we discover a vulnerability here at NSA, we study it, we look at mitigations, we prepare a package of information, and then we bring that forward to the interagency process, where it's debated from all sorts of viewpoints within government, and we come up with the best course of action. If that course of action is to disclose it, then we, NSA, because we discovered it and we know the most about it, will go and go through our responsible disclosure process, work carefully with the vendor. Now, some people may have noticed in the past few years, NSA has been accepting credit for more vulnerabilities. Yeah. And this is part of our charge from our director, General Noxoni, to be a more active participant, a more active member of the cybersecurity community, right? And part of that is understanding these vulnerabilities that we can find and bringing them to the vendor in a way that they can understand the finding, replicate it, and quickly come up with the right fix for their product. And as Christen said, we collaborate with them on that.
Let's dig a little bit more into that tension maybe between the value of disclosing and the value of keeping secret. Both support the defense of the nation, the defense of the defense industrial base, national security systems, the things we are charged with protecting, but there's a tension there. And so when the recent exchange vulnerability was disclosed and NSA accepted credit for that, how did that conversation happen about the value to releasing, for example? Christen, can you talk about that?
Yeah, thanks, Josiah. First, I would say that you can see how these two questions might seem at odds with each other, but really you can often distill it down to the basic question, which is, what is best for the nation? And if what's best for the nation is to fix those holes and get them addressed quickly, then that is what we will do at NSA, and we will assemble our teams to assist with that. In the case of the Microsoft Exchange vulnerabilities, we moved very quickly to disclose because that was the right thing to do.
Neal, how do you handle that question?
So, I was in a lot of those meetings, and that particular vulnerability, we looked at it, we were briefed on it by the discoverers. We realized that the exposure was very, very substantial. And I'll tell you, that one was a pretty quick conversation that whatever benefit that one might potentially have for intelligence, the importance to the nation of getting it fixed was huge. And so we went through that process very quickly. It's important when you go to the vendor to be able to give them the right details. So we got the experts together, we assembled that information, we went through the vet process very quickly, and then we got the information to the company, and they were able to come up with a fix in a pretty quick time.
And the results were very positive. Many people patched, many systems were protected as a result. Yeah. Not every vulnerability is of that scale and magnitude, but every one of them I think is important, right?
Well, they're important to the users of that system.
Exactly.
And it's also important that we understand in our role at NSA of who the users are of these technologies in national security and broader government. And we work with other parts of government who will understand where they're used in, for example, critical infrastructure.
Christen, what do you wish the American public knew about vulnerability discovery?
Thanks, Josiah. What I would like to share with everyone is that the people that hunt for vulnerabilities are really some of the most purposeful and patriotic people that I'm honored to know. It's not always the case where you can have a government job, have the equivalent type of work out in private industry and earning a lot more money. But in the case of vulnerability researchers and discoverers, they're often foregoing very large salaries to work here at NSA and to perform this mission. And they're truly public servants. The second thing that I would want to share with everyone is really just to take this very public opportunity to say that if this work interests you and you have an inclination towards vulnerability discovery and research, NSA is always looking to grow their teams. It is incredibly rewarding to be able to work on really cool technical problems and see how it can impact the world and in some cases save lives.
Neal, one last question that's a little bit lighter. I know you really value the skills and the expertise that's needed to do this kind of work. I want to ask you to think of a vulnerability you admire, one that somebody discovered that you were really impressed by.
Oh, man. So I'm in that process. I get to see all of them.
I know.
So, I think I'll pick one that we disclosed, I think it was a little over a year ago, maybe it might be a year and a half by now, and where I was really impressed with the technical understanding and depth that went into finding it. And that was the vulnerability that was called in the media curveball. That was quite a complex vulnerability in trust foundations within Microsoft Windows. It recently actually was recognized as a best cryptographic vulnerability of the year at the Pawnee Awards at Black Hat.
Yeah.
And I remember when it came up and we got briefed on it, I was just so impressed with how the expert that found it had combined a deep understanding of how public key cryptography works with how a modern operating system employs that cryptography. And that combo, to me, was very impressive.
Well, Christen, Neal, thank you for being here. Thank you for sharing your insights about vulnerability disclosure. And thank you all for watching. Please keep an eye on our Twitter account, @NSA Cyber, for the announcement of future episodes. See you next time.